Am I ready for bed?
Oops, I am so used to starting these episodes by going to bed, but, that's right. We actually passed out last time. So, hello, and, welcome to Wildflowers, where we are starting our day at noon because, we stayed up too late last night and ended up passing out at 2 a.m. Currently, the major thing going on is that we are waiting for Sophia's witch trial, which should take place in a few days. Other than that, we need to try and find Zephyr's runic metal box. Hello, Layla. Pancho. And also, we need to go and see if Bruno's shop is open today, because we need to buy more bait for our fishing whirligig here. It's so cute, fishing away over there. And thanks to our fishing whirligig, we have a few different fish to choose from for Cleocatra.
You still liked that, didn't you, kitty?
The fishing whirligig is so, so great. I love it. It'll go fishing for us, and then we'll sell the fish to Bruno when his shop is open and buy more bait to give to the fishing whirligig to keep it fishing. So let's go see. Is Bruno's shop open today? It's already 3 p.m. Yes, it is.
Now, I can't say I know Natalia well, but I can't imagine how anyone could have a quarrel with Sophia. She's the nicest lady I know, present company excluded.
No. What a sweet thing to say. We have a quest for 3 shrimp for Bruno. Too bad that our fishing whirligig hasn't caught any. But we'll buy it some more bait. And we'll see if it will catch us some shrimp. We'll buy like 20 of each kind of bait. Maybe we should buy even more. Oh well, we'll see. I noticed that Bruno actually sells shrimp himself as well. So if we're really desperate to get that quest done...
I'm worried about the little grommets in town. When adults freak out, the kids can feel it. I keep trying to think of something to say to Juliet, but nothing feels right.
Nah, yeah. Poor Juliet. Having to face the possibility of her mom getting convicted for witchcraft when she isn't even practicing it. All right, top tier with this shop. Do we need a lemon tree seedling? I can't remember. I know that we don't need mulberry or pomegranate seedlings. But lemon? I don't remember. Let's go and investigate the bottom level of the mine a little more. Do some more fishing over there and... Oh, speaking of fishing. Fishy? That was your name, right? Yeah. We have some more bait for you. We'll give you like half of the bait we have. This way, we can also do some fishing at the bottom level of the mine. All right. Let's go. So, last time we, well, Shelby actually had those visions of Natalia. I wonder if there's going to be anything related to that at the coven meeting tonight. Or maybe related to the geological sample quest. We sided with Shelby on that one as well. Because, well, I think the coven should stick together and help each other out and... I don't know. I do trust Giva. I don't think she has any malicious intent. But at the same time, she is very into science and who knows what she might discover.
Is it? It is! A recipe!
Ooh, mulled wine. Nice. So yeah, who knows what Giva might discover, given the chance for that friend of hers to analyze geological samples from the mine. Shaped like a box and has goblin runes on it. Well, thank you very much, hint system. I was hoping for something a little more helpful. I guess, are we going to have to go through each level of the mine? Starting from level 1? Searching for that box? It is beginning to look that way. We didn't find it here at the bottom of the mine. Let's go check out the coven meeting. And while we're there, we'll also water our flowers in the gloaming. And replenish our magic. Nothing new here. Let's go and water our flowers. After this, we'll go back into the mine. I think we are going to have to go through it. Go through each level, starting from level 1. There isn't another path here besides this one, right? We are going to need to wait for something to happen with the second keystone before we can go into different parts of the gloaming, right? Looks that way to me. I was just thinking about that flower that we need for the enchanted silver wire. It did say that they grow wild in the gloaming, but we have yet to see any. So they probably grow wild in some different part of the gloaming. No silver goblin rune box yet. If you see it, but I don't, please let me know in the comments, okay? And maybe like leave a timestamp or something so that I can then watch that part of the video where you saw the box, and then I'll know where to go to find it. I am trying to be very careful looking for the box here and pay close attention to everything. There's just so much here. So, please let me know if you see that box and I don't. We'll have to go back home soon. But, that was the first 5 levels, and no box. I'm going to methodically go through all the mine levels looking for it. And eventually, we should find it. Alright. Don't see it here. Just to make sure, we'll re-explore level 6 tomorrow. I'm thinking maybe we could explore like 5 levels a day or something.
Time for bed.
That will take a chunk of time out of our day, but it won't take like the whole day. And that way, we should be able to run through all the levels in 4 days. More levitation potions, please. Oh, and more essences. mulberries. Ah, we would have needed another lemon tree seedling.
The time for walking slow is done. Quicken my feet and make me run.
That's better. Anything here that we need to do? Yes. Okay. Oh, and we need to go plant that lime tree seedling as well. And we also need summon small things reactivated. So we need a lemon tree seedling and an apple tree seedling. And then we'll have our orchard here complete. Let's actually go see if we can buy the summon small things longer spell and craft it. But first, we'll go see Ariel.
Yes. Give it to Ariel. You might want to have Zephyr teach you how to teleport. Just in case the supports in the mine give out again. Oh, wait! I forgot you're human. Never mind.
Ariel? You're not planning more sabotage, are you? I hope not.
When Juliet played at the wedding, it reminded me of Giacomo. He used to walk around Ravenwood Hollow whistling. One day, maybe Juliet will do the same.
Yeah, maybe. Let's see. Maybe we'll buy all the spells. Yeah. There was the request for 3 summon night spells, for example. Alright, let's also say hello to Zephyr.
I just feel so bad for Sophia. Her daughter, too. To feed your neighbors for years and years and then have them turn on you. I wish Giacomo were still here so he could protect his girls.
Aww. Zephyr. You are so sweet. And I love that you love food. Hello, Layla. Pancho. Let's see about the ingredients that we need for the summon small things longer spell. Oh, Wolf's Bane grows wild in the gloaming. Well, we haven't seen any so far. Maybe we do need access to another part of the gloaming. Hopefully.
Things I want but don't yet have. Get off the ground and in my bag.
hopefully we'll get to put that second keystone to use at some point soon. Because I would really like to get to gathering all of those forager balls from the gloaming. Marty, you are working today.
Come on, Mootilda, please!
Is this a bad time?
I don't even care enough to be embarrassed anymore. I can't get close enough to Mootilda to milk her.
What? She's not a Marty fan?
It's more than that. She got her vaccine shots recently, and now she's skittish. She won't let anyone approach her. I never thought ranching would be easy, but I never imagined it could be this hard. All my life, I worked for my dad in the city, helping him with his consulting business. I'm used to sending rapid-fire emails and picking the perfect spot for a business lunch, but calming animals? Why did I think I could figure that out? Maybe I should just go back to the city.
Just act calm and soothing. Animals can tell when you're desperate.
I know. But it's hard to just be calm when I don't feel that way.
Why don't you try approaching her slowly and speaking in a gentle voice?
If you say so. It's okay, Mootilda. I'm not going to hurt you.
No. You have to use a real baby voice.
Are you a good girl? Are you a cow? Have you ever been a cow? It worked! You are a cattle genius!
I have many talents.
Hey, thanks for helping me. You could have just walked away, but you didn't.
Aw. All right.
What's so bad about going into the woods, anyway? Would Thoreau ever have written Walden if he hadn't been able to go into the woods?
Yeah, I don't see anything wrong with going into the woods. Oh, Finn, hi.
Miss Joshi said that she studied tornadoes in grad school. So cool. But we never get tornadoes here. Do you think she chased the tornadoes? I know you're not supposed to, but did she?
Well, if she was curious enough about them, I think she probably would have. No matter what you're supposed to and not supposed to do, she is very passionate about science. And about the things that she is curious about. I could totally see her chasing tornadoes. And that's kind of why we need to be a little cautious around her, even though she seems to be a very nice person. We do have a secret that we need to keep.
Looking for pearls?
I was, but I guess I got lost in thought watching the waves. The water here is much colder, but the waves always make me think of La Isla. Not that I even got to visit it much. Growing up, I didn't really feel at home on La Isla, but I didn't really feel at home in the city either. Do you feel at home here in Fairhaven yet?
I think that home is less about a place than it is about the people you are with. Being with loved ones matters the most to me.
That's part of my problem, I guess. When I left the city, I left my family behind. Now it's just me and Angus. Maybe once Angus and I are married, it'll feel more like home here. Oh, listen to me. I'm just babbling out loud. Thanks for listening, Tara.
I guess we were supposed to have that event before he and Angus got married. Yeah, I haven't been the most active with socializing. I've been a little too into the story and quests.
I have a theory. Natalia spends a lot of time hammering things at her forge, right? Maybe she wound up breathing in some fumes or something. Like, she got high on her own supply, you know?
Maybe.
I'm just saying.
Well, that would be a good way of explaining it. Without revealing stuff about magic and wraiths and things. Yeah.
I know Natalia's possessed by a wraith, but can I spit in her drink? Just a little?
No.
Violet, this design is fabulous. You really think so, Sophia? Absolutely. In fact, I want to commission one of these dresses in my size. What do you think, Tara?
Let's be supportive.
This dress is gorgeous. Hey, can I order one in my size as well? Oh my gosh, I'm overwhelmed. I'll get right to work, ladies.
Can I tell you a secret? The design was inspired by a vintage dress that belonged to my mom.
Oh, yes, I think I remember the one you're talking about. Gloria always looks so classic in it.
I can't wear the real one. That's like admitting my mom's never coming back. But this design is my way of paying tribute.
I think that's a lovely idea, Violet.
I just need to get around to fixing my old sewing machine so I can actually make these.
Okay. So, is she really going to have her fashion boutique one day?
Now that I've had more time to process, you know what? I'm angry. At Natalia, sure, but Otto too, what a jerk! All his neighborhood watch is doing is turning neighbors against each other!
Mm-hmm. Not very friendly. I do agree with you, Sophia. Okay, let's go and look at levels 6 to 10 in the mine. See if we can find that box. And please do keep your eye out as well. Just in case it is there, but I don't see it. Nothing here. Nope. A silver box. With the runes on it. Also, it'll probably be something that we can interact with. So that'll also make it easy for us to spot. Because usually we can't interact with any of these things. Oh, that was just a weirdly placed lamp. I was like, what's that glow? But yeah, it was just the lamp. Yeah, I'll probably find it when I come across it, because, as I said, it'll be a thing that we can interact with. And usually, we can only interact with the rocks and sand and clay. Level 9 already. I don't think there's going to be anything new at the coven meeting tonight. But we still do need to water our flowers in the gloaming. So I guess we'll go and take a look at the coven meeting as well. Why not? We will be there anyway. In order to go into the gloaming. Let's just explore level 10 first. Then we'll have levels 11 to 15 for tomorrow. And levels 16 to 20 for the day after. If we don't end up finding the box this way, we can always try scrying. I don't think scrying for the box directly was an option. But we could always scry for Zephyr. And then maybe the light will lead us to Zephyr's missing possession. Who knows if we can't just bump into the box while running through the mine levels. Maybe we'll try the scrying thing. Those have been watered, so I guess we do have a little bit of time before we need to go to bed. Let's get back to the mine. I think we have time to run through one more level. Yeah, these are all things that we can't interact with. The piles of boxes and stuff. So when we do come across one that we can interact with, it'll be pretty noticeable. Yeah. We have almost all of our energy left. Let's use some of it, but also try to get to bed before 2 a.m. We need to get going soon. And tomorrow we'll look for that box on levels 12, 13, 14, and 15. Yeah, we need to go. Like, right now. Alright, let's save the game here and continue looking for that box tomorrow. Thank you so much for spending time with me here on the Mellow. It was lovely to have you. I'd like it if you'd leave me a like, and if you're not already subscribed, then please do subscribe to conveniently keep up with my content and to show me that you want to keep watching my videos. Remember to be kind to yourself. Have a lovely rest of your day. And I'll see you next time.